hate to admit, even with the most compelling storyline or enthralling narration in your PowerPoint presentation, if the slides are static, you may lose interest from your audience. Motion adds life to your presentation. Hi, I'm Les from PowerUp Training, where my decades of experience becomes your expertise for free. There's something about the human brain that is entertained by moving objects. We are like cats and a laser pointer. Make it move, make it move, make it move. PowerPoint knows that. Human nature rules and provides you with five tools to add motion to your slide deck. Do you know all five techniques? There are tools to add basic bullet animation plus special custom motion animation within a slide. There are also other tools that let you add visual movement for classic transitions between slides in the conference room or virtual conferencing presentations. And more recently, there are the PowerPoint animation tools to create nonlinear, interactive slide zoom shows. And finally, the amazing Morph Transition tool that is typically misunderstood. Here at PowerUp Training, we have created 11 different free YouTube tutorials on the basics and some of the advanced creative uses of these techniques. Plus, our viewers want to know which motion command should I use and when. So this tutorial will provide a look at eye-opening uses of these five motion tools, including when and where to effectively pull these out of your PowerPoint bag of tricks. And no, you don't need to use the 27 separate animations made just for this slide. So let's power up and go learn about adding life with five motion tools in PowerPoint. PowerPoint gives you options to add life to your presentation with motion. But which tool should you use? Let's fly through the choices to help you keep track of which motion tool does what and when to apply each of the tools to your individual slides or whole presentation. PowerPoint has five separate motion tools spread across the menus, and each has a specific need. Some of them will focus on adding life to a single slide, while others will be between slides, and there's the more recent magical tools. The single slide tool are centered around the animation menu tool that is self-contained on a single slide, while the transition menu tool and the separate slide zoom tool will animate between slides. And lastly, there's the morph transition that would appear to be just between slides, but it can provide fabulous magic, giving amazing life to what appears to be just a single slide. Note that the slide zoom and the morph tools work only in the most recent versions of PowerPoint. Let's do some housekeeping before we dive in. Adding motion to PowerPoint goes back to almost the beginning, or at least back to PowerPoint 2003. Over the years, the feature sets have merged and are now almost on par between Windows and the Apple macOS desktop platform. New tools have been added, with some totally cool special effects introduced into PowerPoint 2019 up to the present Office 365. This presentation was completely created in PowerPoint 365, and if you want to dissect how some of the motion tools were employed, including notes on how the slides were constructed, stay to the end on how to download the file. Also note that I've added some extra highlighting with the screen recording tool of Camtasia. These lower third titles and other pop-ups will all use red outlines to indicate the use of Camtasia. Finally, look for the rippling dimples on the screen and hear a mouse click to know that I'm advancing the slideshow. Listen. The two motion tools are centered around bringing life to a single slide, the long-standing object or bullet animation tool, and the close cousin tool called Amination Motion Path. Let's start off with bullet and object animation. Adding animation to a slide is a foundational motion tool that has been in PowerPoint forever. It's a simple hiding items on the slide page until you click to reveal, thereby focusing your audience's attention to a specific part of the slide. And with each click, the next item appears, hopefully in sync with your presentation topic. If you'd like to introduce each bullet point line by line, you do need to practice to keep everything in sync. It is embarrassing to be talking and not having your bullet point item revealed to your audience until after you finish the topic. Most people are familiar with the standard entrance animation, such as we have here using the zoom effect, but you can stack them together, such as the entrance and animation, and then with the second click, you can add an emphasis, such as the spin move, which in my professional presentation is a bit over the top, but there are many other more classy emphasis animations. Lastly, there is the exit animation, which may not be a full exit. As you see here, the action is just to change the font color to indicate that the topic has been covered. But if you want, you can go after the entrance animation and add in the second exit that will have the bullet item leave the slide. So far, all of our examples have been text-based or bullet point samples, but you can apply the slide animation to not just text, but to much more. In fact, for text alone, there are options to have the complete text box become animated or just the lines of text, as we've been demonstrating on this slide, but you can even animate one word at a time or even one character at a time as if you're typing along. Objects. If it's selectable on the slide page, you can animate it for entrances, emphasis, and exits. The most recent version of PowerPoint has become quite sophisticated when animated complex items like this smart art object, or even this graph where you can stage the reveal of individual data sets as you present. Slide object animation is standard PowerPoint tools for a reason. It is simple to apply, but still provides advanced options to enhance your slide deck. Animated motion paths was added to the toolbox with PowerPoint 2013 and going forward to the most recent versions. It gives you some very sophisticated ways of creating unique motion paths. You can control the movement of text objects. Watch this as we take the Move Me from the top down to the bottom right-hand corner with a click, or any selectable object on the slide page, like this red arrow shape, which will travel to the far side of the page. If you can click it on the page, you can move it to anywhere on the page, like this graph. Do note that it's only within the slide that the motion can happen, but you can set a motion to go off stage, which is outside the viewable boundary of the slide. You can even add multiple timings to do some wild movements, such as with this bumblebee entering the slide, then following a zany motion path before exiting the slide completely. The two tools of animation and animation motion path covers what can be done inside a single slide. So let's go on to the next category of adding life between slide transitions in a slideshow, where we can find two more tools. The slide transition tool has been another motion foundational tool built into PowerPoint from almost the beginning. It has a number of choices and visual sophistication enhancements that is improved with each new version of PowerPoint. The concept is to remove the sudden jolt of moving from one slide to the next slide by substituting either a subtle slide change or a more showy special effect as you progress through your slideshow on the screen. It is simple to apply, just choose and click, but it's easy to go overboard to turn a classy presentation into a cartoon-looking show like this paper airplane transition. As we discussed in some of our design tutorials, it is best to stay consistent as the transition should not be the star of the show, but you can use it to get attention of your audience if you're bringing up a new concept such as this honeycomb transition. And for complex slideshows, you can add automation to advance your presentation from slide to slide on a timed event show without a mouse click. It is worth exploring all of your choices to know what is in your slide transition bag of tricks. But if you want, here's our jump start of my 10 favorite transition, a tutorial that is listed above. A more complex tool for moving between slides is the Slide Zoom tool, available in Office 2019 up to the latest Office 365 desktop program. It should not be confused with the animation zoom effect or the actual slide transition called zoom, but it is a powerful extra tool found in the Insert ribbon menu. And actually, it is three tools in one. Option one is the slide zoom. Option two is the summary zoom. And third is the section zoom. The slide that you're currently looking at is made up of three slide zoom thumbnails, which when I click on the slide zoom, it will jump to that slide. And it was as easy to create as to just drag the thumbnail slide in the normal view onto my canvas and then position its eyes. The thumbnail is live, meaning that if I change the slide content, the thumbnail will auto-update. And when I'm done with the slide, I just click and it returns me back to the original summary page. No hyperlink coding required. The second iteration is a bit more sophisticated for a larger slideshow. In the creation process, once the summary command is issued, up will pop a preview of all the slides, where you can then click on the key chapter slides, and PowerPoint will create a single new slide with each thumbnail. And then, when you're done with the slide in that collection during your presentation, it will return you back to the main summary slide. This has the added benefit of letting you create an interactive presentation, as you can jump to slides out of the normal serial progression. As I can jump to the whale slide again by just clicking on the thumbnail and then clicking again to return back to the main slide and electing to go to any one of the collections. In this case, let's go to number three, section zoom. Section zoom is really just a variation of the summary zoom, but built for slideshows that already have implemented sections. Sections are ways to organize large collections of slides. See our special tutorial listed above. The sections can be seen here in the slide sorter view. The summary zoom will let you link a master chapter slide that, when created, brings the first slide from each of the sections together as a hyperlinked table of contents. And now, any thumbnail can be clicked in the presentation to jump to the collection of the section slides. And when reaching the section's last slide, the show will then return back to the summary zoom slide. This is fantastic for group presentations with multiple presenters, and I've been using this tool throughout our presentation here. So far, we've covered four tools, each with many variations on how to apply motion to your presentation. Two tools for the specific slide animation, and two more tools for adding motion in between slides during the slideshow. But now I want to introduce the most underutilized tool that can work both as an inside a slide tool and a motion between slide tool. The Morph Transition tool is languishing in the slide transition collection of dozens of different effects, but it can act like a standalone multifunctional tool. At a high level, Morph Transitions looks at two slides and decides which items are the same on both slides and how they may change from one to the next. Examine these two slides. The left slide has a brown box on the left edge, while the right slide has a blue box on the right edge. So the Morph tool will motion the box across the slide as we change from one slide to the next, and it will change the colors from brown to blue in a fade to blue transition fashion. So here's the slide, and watch the brown box slide over and morph to a blue box on the second slide. I will go back to the previous slide, but watch how the words the, tools, Microsoft all travel from one side to the next as those three words exist on both slides. And as a bonus, that cool tool is easy to put together and takes much less time than using the more laborious Motion Path tool. Let's look closer at how you can create a dramatic page intro. To create motion actions from one slide to the next takes a little staging. On our first slide, our slide canvas has a simple black and gray background, but outside the slide canvas view area, I have placed three objects that won't be visible on this page, but we will put them on the second slide page in three locations so that the image, the title, and the subtitles will slide into place. Here's the first background slide, and with the next slide, the objects will glide in as if it's on the same page. Yes, Morph Transition is a slide transition between two slides, but your viewer does not have to know the magic of how you're achieving these cinematic effects. Watch how we bring these separate slides into a movie-like sequence. With each click of the mouse, I'm able to focus on a specific point in time for my project timeline. What is happening behind the scene is just three boxes moving positions from one slide to the next. So, we've covered the five tools: motion inside of a slide, motion between slides in a slideshow, plus the super magical morph transitions that can work between slides or appear to be on a single slide. So when do you use these tools, and how do you learn to use them? PowerUp Training has five free YouTube tutorials for: I need to add some small motion to a single slide to focus my audience on a specific point, then use bullet object animation. I want a topic or an object to be emphasized so that my audience does not miss the point. Then use the animation with stack actions or give it a boost with a motion path animation tool. I need to add a professional flow to my whole presentation from slide to slide with some extra punch for star slides. Then the solution is to use one of the many slide transitions special effects. I want an amazing movement of individual objects from one slide to the next to bring coolness and continuity. Then work with the Morph Transition tool. And for wow, then creatively use the Morph Transition with advanced motion management capabilities. Or for interactive presentations, as we've been witnessing on this Zoom Create slide, use the Zoom tool to break out of the normal linear PowerPoint slideshows to become interactive. To master these tools, you may need more than just the one set of YouTube tutorials that I've been listing here. These tools are so amazing and diverse that we at PowerUp Training have created 11 different videos to help you look like a PowerPoint presentation wizard. Find all of them on our YouTube channel or in the listed playlist above. And if you want to peek inside to see how this presentation was created, I've posted the full PowerPoint file on our website for you to take apart and learn. Inside, you will find the notes portion of the slides that provides a bit more details on how I constructed the show page by page. Your presentation will not be the same once you master all five of these tools. Whether you explore them on your own or elect to dive deeper into any of our 11 matching tutorials, go ahead and use these tools. I've made it easier to see all of these videos by creating a YouTube playlist listed above. And as an alternative, you could visit our free PowerUp School at power-up.training to see these tutorials, plus get a download of this presentation file. See the link in the YouTube notes below. Don't forget to like and share this video, and do subscribe to get more videos like this and be notified about any new tutorial arrivals. Until next time, go power up.